Hi everyone, my name is Xin Tian. I consider myself as an intermediate beginner. I just started coding not too long ago. So today I'm going to share a bit about my journey of learning Ruby on Rails. 2 years ago, I was kicked out from NUS master program and my self-confidence was at all-time low. So a friend of mine introduced me to the concept of programming and showed me what can be done with code. So I was intrigued and soon I became interested in all things tech and startup. To me, what attracted me to code is not coding itself, but the magic of being able to turn any idea into a useful product. So, like a lot of you, I learned HTML, CSS, and JavaScript on free online resources by myself. However, it came to a stage that I did not know how to proceed further and apply what I have learned to creating a real-life application. So it was after I joined a hackerspace event that I found out about TechLadies. So TechLadies is a community for women who love programming. And one of the activities that they do is TechLadies Bootcamp, where women learn how to code by creating products for non-profit organizations under the guidance of volunteer coaches. So I applied to the coding bootcamp immediately and was super excited when I was accepted. This experience was a life-changing one. So for the pioneer batch, 9 of us were selected over 120 applicants, and each of us come with our own stories and motivation of wanting to learn how to code. Some of us aspire to become a software engineers, and some of us want to build our own startups. So we work on 3 projects over an 8-week period. Through this experience, there are a few things that I found to be really useful if, let's say, you are helping a beginner to learn how to code. Let me quickly bring you through that. Firstly, theory versus practical. Completing lessons and collecting badges from code school and code academy only brings one that far. So what's next? What I have learned is that the best way of bridging the gap between knowledge and practice is to dive headfirst into a project and solve real-world problems. So working on the TechLadies project for Engineers.SG bridged the gap between theory and practical for me. Engineers.SG is a non-profit organization that helps to document the Singapore startup and tech scene. And they are the one that filming this conference. So my team's project was to improve the app's user experience. So I have to pick up Ruby, Rails, and programming concept and all other tools that you can see here and apply the knowledge onto Engineers.sg app. So working on the project really helped me to see all the programming concepts come to life. Secondly, mentorship is important. I'm sure all of you here can relate to having a mentor or a role model in the tech community or at your workplace. So as a beginner in any field, having a mentor is very, very important. Like me, a lot of us today had someone who was willing to give us a kick in the right direction. So our TechLadies coaches was very helpful, and I improved tremendously under their help. From my coaches, I learned practical advice, programming best practices, and non-technical knowledge such as working and communicating within a team. Just a quick side note, if you or your company is interested in paying it forward, TechLadies is a community-led initiative and is always on the lookout for support. Please come and find us at the booth outside, or you can actually send an email to Elisha, the founder of TechLadies, for sponsorship and coaches. Apart from programming, one thing I have learned is the importance of community. A community helped me to learn from each other, and that is definitely important because each of us have different knowledge set. So I'm constantly being inspired by the determination and perseverance of my fellow tech ladies. So after the bootcamp has ended, I found that there wasn't an environment for beginners to present their work and learn from each other. So a fellow tech lady and I kickstarted an initiative called Tech Ladies TED Talk. This series of events features beginners sharing what they have learned or built. With this, we hope that beginners will gradually improve their skills and build confidence in programming. So coding has completely changed the way I approach problems. I'm now being able to communicate effectively with my company tech team in order to solve the issue faced by my department. So one day in future, I hope that I'll be good enough to create a real-world application that can bring values to others. That's all for today. This is my first time speaking to so many people on this stage. I really hope that you have enjoyed it. Please feel free to drop me an email if you have any questions. Thank you.